What happens to text objects when we open older files? Or save files from the current version back to an older version? Let's start by opening a legacy file that contains text. In this case, a CorelDRAW 12 file. If the file is very old, and perhaps the computer has also changed in the meantime, then the first thing we'll probably see is the Panose Font Matching window. Panose Font Matching gives us access to a list of fonts that can be used as substitutes for fonts used in a document, but not found on our computer. Or perhaps we do have the font installed, but a different version. I can see here, for example, that although I do have the first three fonts in the list, I have newer updated versions that could be used to replace the older versions of the fonts. The last font I don't have, so I can either accept Arial as the font to replace it, or choose a different font. We can set options for font matching. When we substitute fonts with Panose Font Matching, we can accept the default substitute font, or we can choose any available font as a substitute. This substitution can be applied temporarily or permanently. If we choose permanent, this permanently replaces the missing font with the substitution. And when we save and reopen the file, the new font is used. If we choose temporary, the missing font is replaced with the substitution for the duration of the current session only. We can also build a list of exceptions to font substitutions. Exceptions override the font substitutions recommended by the Panose Font Matching feature. A list of exceptions can be useful when you share drawings and documents across platforms, because sometimes the same font is spelled differently on each platform. If you are working with older files frequently, it makes sense to set up Panose Font Matching in advance. To do this, we go to Tools, Options, CorelDRAW, Text, Fonts, Panose Font Matching. I'll leave the first option set to text. The default substitution font is Arial. I could change this if I wanted to another font that I use frequently in my documents. And finally, I have here the exceptions. Here I can enter the name of a missing font and choose which alternative font I always want to replace this with. To build a list of exceptions to font substitutions, in the Panose Font Matching Exceptions dialog box, type the name of the missing font in the missing font box. Choose a font that is installed on your computer from the substituted font list. Click Add Exception. You can substitute multiple missing fonts with a single font by holding down Shift key and selecting the fonts in the missing font list. Although the topic of this video is working with legacy files, we should also think about future-proofing our files. What can we do to avoid having the fonts we're using today showing up as missing fonts in the future? Although we can't avoid our files being opened on other systems that perhaps don't have the fonts we used, by embedding the fonts in our documents, these will become accessible to CorelDRAW, and the only Panose Font Matching request we might get is if this other system is using a newer version than the one we created the design with originally. CorelDRAW Graphics Suite includes the Corel Font Manager. The Font Manager not only allows us to manage the fonts on our system, but it also tells us about whether a font can be embedded or not. Under the Embedding Rights filter, we could, for example, sort our fonts by their embedding permissions. Or we can click on a single font we're thinking of using, and under the font information, just check if it can be embedded or not. So, what do these options tell us? First of all, these are the types of embedding that the font designer has decided to grant to the user. Editable means that the user can open the file and change the text using that font inside the file. Installable. This is the same as editable, and some software will allow the extraction of the font out of the file so that it can then be installed on a different system. However, CorelDRAW does not support this. So, as far as CorelDRAW users are concerned, this is the same as editable. No embedding does what it says on the tin, and the fonts can't be embedded at all. In this case, we will get the font substitution dialog if we open such files on a system that doesn't have the fonts installed already. Preview and print. Here we can only view the file and print it. The user is not allowed to make any changes to the text using this font. If he or she tries, they will see the font substitution dialog before they can enter text edit mode. So going forward, when creating design work that you might need to edit or pass on to a third party in the future, I would always recommend using the Font Manager to find fonts that are editable slash embeddable. That way, you won't need to use Panose Font Matching to try to find something similar, and then have to reformat the new text. Returning to our legacy CorelDRAW file now, our file here is asking us to update it. Why? In CorelDRAW X6, some serious changes were made to the text formatter. The text formatter is what decides where each character goes, and how many characters fit on one line. Generally speaking, if you are opening older files and you are asked to upgrade, then you should always choose the upgrade option, as it then allows you to use OpenType features. The only downside is that in some cases, you might observe some small spacing changes, or perhaps some default ligatures kicking in. Because of that, more or less words can fit on a line, and then the rest of the paragraph flow can end up being very different to the original, causing the text to no longer fit in the frame, for example. Although you have the option to update the text, you will still be able to revert back using the undo option. Normally, the text in an open legacy document will appear only minimally changed, if at all. It's now time to take a look at what happens to text objects when we save files from the current version back to an older version. I have several text objects here that give us a fantastic example of how the OpenType engine in CorelDRAW works. If I select the text and click on this handle here, I'm able to choose from one of the many alternative styles that are available in this font. The styles and style sets available depend on what the font manufacturer has built into the font. If I now try to save this document back to an older version of CorelDRAW, X5 for example, that didn't support OpenType features, then I'll get this message box pop up. This tells us that by saving back to X5, we'll lose some of the new features from this version. We are given two options. If we choose to keep the appearance, the text will be converted to curves. So although the text will appear the same, it can no longer be edited with the text tool, and any further changes will have to be made with the shape tool. The second option, to keep the text editable, keeps the objects as text, but will likely remove the beautiful swashes we see here and just present us with standard characters. I hope that so far, we have managed to allay some of the fears that you might have had regarding protecting legacy files when opening these in the latest version of CorelDRAW.